That's a cool piece. Ooh, look at that owl. Hi.
Welcome back to my channel. This is Fate of the Vintage and I'm Colleen. Today, I was not planning on going shopping. So, the last video I put out, I had gone thrifting. I was really excited. I was planning on going to a couple of antique shops after I stocked my booth at Pandora's Barn, but I ended up chatting. I socialized for a little too long and I ran out of time before I had to go home and get the boys off the bus. So that was yesterday. And I was just kind of planning on just doing my thing at home, working on bookwork, cleaning the house, you know, the usual. But today's so nice out that my husband and I went to lunch. And then afterwards, I'm like, I'm just going to go to the antique shop. I don't want to sit at home today. It's so pretty. Who would have anticipated that it would look like this the week before Valentine's Day in central New York? It is sunny. It is 58 degrees. So, spur of the moment shopping trip. So, let's go inside. I am at the Farm Antiques today. So, let's see what's inside. All right, music's a little loud in here, so I'll do what I can. Ooh, that's cool. For 28. I love this booth. She has some amazing stuff in here. Oh, look at all this Amberina. She's got good prices too. $9 for this Viking dish. Let me look at that a little closer. I think that's about a $20 dish, if I'm remembering correctly. I don't see any chips or cracks. It might be my first purchase. So pretty. And I know this will glow under black light. Yes, love it. All right. Oh man, look at this. Oh, it's so pretty. It's huge. I love that color. Who makes that? I'm trying to remember. Is this McCoy? It is McCoy. Sand dollar pattern, $190. That's a decent price. Oh man, look at that. So pretty. All right, I'll put Barbie back. All right. Oh, and what are you? What are you? Oh, your sign? Foster for $30. I've seen this Foster name before, and I want to say that's pretty on par for what his stuff usually goes for. But that's still a really good, it's a pretty good price. Hello. So I'm in the same booth, and I was looking at the shelf right where I picked up that Viking, and there's this rainbow glass pitcher for $8 with the original sticker on it and with the yellow handle on it. Pretty sure this will glow as well with cadmium. And now I'm looking at it. No, we're okay. For a second there, I thought there was a crack, but I think we're all right. Oh, so pretty. I just love this booth so much. Oh, what's this face? Oh, this looks kind of like Blanco. If I remember right, for $25. I'm not sure what blank this particular shape is going for right now, but it's so pretty. Look at that color. And look at the swung vase. I'm gonna go look at that. I know I've looked at it in the past, but and I can't remember how much it was. So I gotta look again. That's just how things go. Set that vase down gently. See if I can reach it without knocking anything over. Got it. $45. That's a pretty color. Yeah, it's one of those where it's kind of right on the edge. So I think I'm going to hold off. I'm going to put it back gently. That's cool. I think that's Viking too. Oh, so pretty. What is this vase? Is that an opalescent? Yeah, Fenton piece.
20. I've never seen this one. That's strange. That's a strange marking. Interesting. And more McCoy. Oh, she's got some great stuff. So much good stuff. Oh, okay. I'll let you know if I find anything else. Oh, look at all the Christmas things. For $20. That's a pretty good price. But it's not Christmas anymore. And he's not in the greatest condition. Oh, that's tempting. You are tempting, sir. Oh, what I'm trying to keep talking because I know how this works with the music. And YouTube gets mad at you if you have too much copyrighted music in the background. So, oh, Fenton custard. How much did I want for that? 40. Oh, that's tempting. Because that is the... Oh, what pattern is that? Just out of reach. Cherry blossom, I think. So pretty. Oh, look at these. Ooh, so pretty. Oh, that glows, too. I've had those before. Oh, you, sir, are adorable. For 10. So cute. All right, I'll let you know if I find anything. Are these Shawnee? Okay, that's bleak. All right, see you in a second. Okay, I am trying to talk over this. 24, that is Fenton, I believe, 1930s, the cased pink. This booth also has a good amount of Fenton in it. Let's see, so much good stuff. And I'm trying to keep things a little on the small side of what I'm finding today because I am shopping today for my first Knickknacks live show. So with that, I'm trying to keep things small, but I'm really excited about it. Ooh, look at this sucker. Depression ashtray 18. That is really cool. Betcha that glows. Actually, give me a minute. I'm gonna go get my keys. So this actually doesn't glow. It's hard to see, but it doesn't. So look. That doesn't glow either. See, now I'm batting 1,000. See, that glows. So, I'm gonna leave it behind. It's a pretty heavy piece. And I don't want to pick up something that heavy for my first live. Oh, you guys are cute. Two dachshunds. They don't look very old, though. All right, move on. Next booth. Okay, this is interesting. This is WC 30% off anything over 10. This is $15. This might be Italian. Oh, that is broken there. Okay. I'll leave that behind. The handle's a bit busted. Oh, that's so pretty, though. I love the color. All right. But I am going to peek a little harder in here. I think I can open that without a key. Here, let me move this really quick. I'm going to see if I can get in that. All right, we're in. All right, first this little apple for 30. That is, what does that say? What do you say? Oh, Lord. Here, I'll look at that in a minute. That's for 30. Scooch over the little angel. Look at this little egg. It's not quite as exciting as I thought it was. But look at that piece of Fenton. They have $275 on it, which is a pretty standard price for that, plus 30% off. Very cool. That is, I think, called After the Rain. It's a beautiful piece. It has all the signatures of all the Fentons on the bottom. Super cool. I've never seen one in person. I've only seen them on other people's live sales. But I'm going to try to decipher this apple and see if that's coming home with me. Okay, I've deciphered this mark. It is Angelo Intaglio, and 30% off of 30. That puts it actually right about what it runs for on eBay. So I'm going to go ahead and put this back. And I will spin it so that the price is forward. Close this. And I will put this back there. Like I was never here. All right, this booth is always a ton of fun. They've got good prices, and it's just so good. 23 for Occupied Japan feathered birds. Oh, those are neat. And I'm still trying to talk as much as I can because, yeah, the music's quite loud, but that's okay. You're fun. 16. What else have we got here? I'm not sure what I'm looking for when it comes to this sale, because this is my first live sale on knickknacks. So I don't know if I need to focus more on glass. This is a Fenton cat. This is cobalt for 22. Or if I should focus on other things. I don't know. So, oh, you're fun for 10. I can show you guys. You are goobery looking goober. Pico Occupied Japan. Little planter. I did pick up a couple Occupied Japan pieces from this booth the last time I was in. 14, that's about right on that. And those haven't sold yet, so I'm hesitant to pick up more Occupied Japan pieces. Oh, what's this face? Oh, gentle. Okay. Here, controlled fall. Controlled fall. Okay, we're good. That is pretty. $9. That is neat. I don't know. It's not signed, which I wouldn't expect it to be. The handles make me think possibly Venetian. The color makes me think words and stuff. Also Italian. Empoli. There we go. But I don't know. That base makes me think Asian. I don't know why. I might leave this for now. Because this is in Brewerton, I'm in Brewerton approximately every week or so. Actually, because that fell down, I'm going to scooch this over here into this empty spot. Look at that. Works out perfectly. But yeah. So if I change your mind on it, it's right here. 10 on that crackle glass pitcher. All right. Want something unique and really fun. And so I'm going to keep searching. Okay. I think the winners out of that booth are going to be these two owls. We got the little brutalist brass on a pedestal and a little Polish pottery guy. Pretty happy about them. Whenever I'm here, I can't help but just kind of stare into this particular case. So this is a little Tiffany piece, and this is a Lowitz. Look at that Art Deco, so pretty. Look at this Steuben candlestick holder. Ugh, gorgeous. You just gotta look at it. Oh, look at that vase. That's pretty. So pretty. All right, just to point out, all right, that I believe is Dugan, but look at this. That is Victorian. I think it's missing part of the tin lid. It was $125. Now they have it down to $75. That's tempting. But I'm going to hold off. I don't know what my market's going to be like exactly on knickknacks. So I'm holding off for like till I know. So many cute things. Look at that little was that peacock? Oh, look at the deer. That is a jewelry holder, like a ring holder. So fun. House hippo, anyone? It's a candle made by who? Treasures of the Pharaohs by Elizabeth Arden. Huh. Interesting. There's, I think this is a princess house. Cobalt bunny 7. I do have a clear glass bunny at home, so I think I'm going to hold off on that for now. Okay, now I don't usually find anything in this booth. I don't think it's restocked very frequently, but this just caught my eye. They are absolutely adorable, and they are marked, I think that says Holland. Looks an awful lot like Holland to me. And just look at their little faces for $8. Now, price is in question, because this booth is also perpetually half off sale for glassware. Does that include pottery? I don't know. But I'm okay with this at $4 or $8, because look at them little faces. They're adorable. It's always so fun to shop here because the booths are just so eclectic and different, where you'll find like a fantastic Pyrex, salt and pepper shakers. You'll find vintage barber shop stuff. And then also like toys and trolls in the same booth. Like, it's so much fun. You never know what you're going to find. The Anna Lee dolls always catch my eye, but I'm not even going to look at the prices on those because they're both Valentine's Day and it's a little late for that. Because when I do my live show, which I haven't even scheduled yet, oh, that's still 34. That's a hard pattern to find in McCoy. Because even though I haven't scheduled my show yet, back to that. And it's probably going to take place before Valentine's Day. There's not going to be enough time to get the items to people before Valentine's Day. So, I'm not going to sell Valentine's Day themed things when they're not going to get to them before Valentine's Day. Does that make sense? Nah. Either way. Oh, that's pretty. They have $145 on that. Oh, that's a cool piece. Oh, look at that owl. Hi. Okay. I have to be careful because the radio is just loud throughout the entire building. I know I've said that multiple times, but it's still the thing. Okay. So, I'm going to show you a little tidbit of information that I have run across. So, when you see these little plates, these are actually teacup plates. They're not saucers. They're teacup plates. They're little plates that you would get with your teacup and saucer. And while you're drinking from your cup, it might be too hot. So you put your teacup on there. And it used to be that saucers were a lot deeper in, like the sides of them were a lot deeper than they are today. Like when you're looking at this, the edges will come up higher than on current flatware or china. Anyways. So you would actually pour the tea into the saucer and then set the teacup on the little tea plate and then drink out of your saucer where it's cooler in temperature. Here we have some Murano bowls. That's beautiful with the Millefiori. Come on, focus. Focus. All right, so here we have $35 on that one. 32 on this one, and 18 on this one. I like the price on this one better, but it's a little bit more scratched up and a little bit more plain. I think I'll hold off on that. Oh, hello. It's perfume. I think. Yeah. Oh, dabber is broken. Come on, focus. Focus. Aren't you focusing? But they're asking 15 for it. If I remember right, this design is, oh Lord, it just flew out of my brain. But it's a little bit more mass produced. It's very pretty, but just, oh, come on. Focus, there we go. Very pretty though. What else can we see in here? Try not to get you guys too seasick while also moving quickly enough to where I don't get keep catching the radio. Oh, reaching. It's Murano art glass. Yeah, how much? 18 for this little dish. It's not super exciting. Let's see what's up here. Oh, you're cute. For $4. It's a bisque though. I'm kind of torn when it comes to bisque finish, which is that like satin finish. I'm just not a fan. Like some things, it has to be like extra cute in order for me to really go for it when it's a bisque finish. EAPG, got some carnival glass.
I spent $36 in there today. Not a big shopping trip, but I'm happy with what I got. The Viking, the rainbow, all the little figurines. I'm really happy with that. but I do have plenty at home that I can put in the knickknacks show. So I will put at the end of the video when I have that scheduled, and I look forward to seeing you all there. And if you like this kind of content, like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you for coming along in my adventures, and I'll see you next time. Bye.